I've owned a Watersnake Combat Electric Motor for a while now, so I thought I'd do a review on it. So, without further ado, here it is. The Watersnake Combat Electric Motor Review. There are a lot of options on the market when it comes to electric trolling motors. So, why did I decide to choose the Watersnake Combat? The price. At $600, it's a steal, right? Well, you have to remember that it doesn't have the features that a more expensive unit would, such as spot lock, which is found on more expensive models and competitors' models. Now, let's talk build quality. The overall build quality of this unit is solid. The sides, the shaft clip, and the head unit are made out of plastic, and the rest of the unit is made out of metal. It also came with a quick release plate, which is made of nylon. Now, let's talk accessories. The unit comes with a remote and a foot pedal. The foot pedal and remote are made out of plastic. Now, the remote isn't as responsive as I would have hoped, and the range isn't that great. The foot pedal, on the other hand, is, well, pretty responsive. The only downside to the foot pedal, though, is that it isn't wireless, but maybe that would affect the responsiveness of it. It is relatively easy to deploy and stow the electric motor. However, I sometimes have trouble deploying it. So that's something that I'll have to fix myself. If you are experiencing this issue, all you gotta do is get some silicone spray and spray it on these grooves here. As well as the shaft. This will resolve the issue.
Push it down, there you go.
Connecting the electric motor to a battery is a very simple process. Just connect the positive wire to the positive terminal and vice versa. I find that a 65 ampere hour battery is enough for a day. However, I will be upgrading batteries in the future, which I also recommend you do. The electric motor has this black box, which is a reset switch, and this has come in handy a few times. Okay, well, now onto some of my complaints. First of all, this part here moves around a bit. Now, I find that it moves a lot when I have a high thrust and accelerate. Now, this doesn't affect the performance of the unit, however, it gets annoying after a while. Secondly, when you change directions, the little motor that moves the shaft around is very loud, and I'm sure it's louder than its competitors. However, I could be wrong, because I haven't owned or heard for myself the competitors. This concludes my review on the Watersnake Combat Motor. If you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing. And check out the other videos that I've done on this motor. Or if fishing is something that you'd rather, check out the videos on screen right now. And there'll be more fishing videos coming shortly, so stay tuned.